When putting together a logo design proposal document, one of the most crucial things you can do is include in-situ visuals because they help us demonstrate to a client a logo design working in real-life instances. Here I am in Illustrator, and this is a typical logo proposal document I will put together for a client. Now, as part of my proposal document, I will often include in-situ visuals. For this project, I'm working on a logo design for a music festival. And at the end of the document, you can see I have a few pages showing how the logo can be used in a series of visuals. One in particular shows how the logo can be used on a flag. For many logo design projects, I could imagine a logo would be used in a fun format like this, which would be great to show in a proposal document. In this video, I'm going to show you a really cool flag template you can invest in and how to use it to show off your logo design. So let's get into it. So here I am with my logo design process checklist. Once we have created our logo designs and we have checked each task, we can now move into step one in phase four. So the first step in the present logo designs phase is place logo into in-situ visual examples. Now, using in-situ visuals like this in your proposal can really bring your design to life and wow your client. Now, it can be time-consuming and difficult to take perfect photos and build in-situ visuals ourselves, especially if you're on a project with a tight budget or timeline, where you want to spend more time on other parts of the process. One method to save time is to invest in in-situ mockups. A small investment for a mockup template can save you hours of work, which will ultimately save you money. For this in-situ visual, I'm going to use a mockup template from a really cool flag pack. So here I am in Photoshop, and these are some images I have generated using a really cool flag template. I really like how these look, and they are perfect for my project. So the template I used for this is the Flag Mockups Pack, which I got over on DesignCuts. This is a really cool flag bundle and actually comes complete with three flag shapes with optional indoor and outdoor lighting. I particularly like how each flag is cut out so you can easily place in a background, so you can place the flag in context. If you want to take a closer look at the details, specifications, and invest in this template, you can find the link in the free index PDF document that accompanies this course and in the info section of this video. Links are in the description. So for my proposal doc, I only used one flag example, though created two instances and popped them onto one page to include in my proposal document. So let's take a look at how I did this. So once you have purchased the template, you will find three folders, one for each flag style, one for bow, feather, and sail. Included in each folder are PSD files, one for indoor and one for outdoor, which you can quickly open in Photoshop and drop your design into. So one that stood out to me was the bow flag, and I wanted to create an outdoor scene. So I'll start with this one. So with the template open, we will see in the layers panel, the clear smart object layer we can drop our artwork into at the top. Below, we have three styles of stand, ground spine, crossbar, and base plate, which we can toggle on and off. So I'll double click into this smart object, and here I can place in my design. So into Illustrator, into my proposal document, I want to see how my wide word mark combination mark logo would work on the flag. I designed this logo to work in wide spaces, so this could look great running down the length of the flag. So I'll select my artwork, copy, and back into Photoshop, I'll paste my logo, scale, and position. With my logo in place, I then need to set the right color background. So into my proposal doc, I'll select my base color, double click on the fill option, copy the hex value, then back into Photoshop, I'll double click on the fill option, paste in my hex value, and with the paint bucket tool, I'll click onto the flag base layer. With that done, I'll click Command W on Mac or Control W on Windows to close, save, and I'll be back into my original document. Now, if I come over to the flag layer, inside I'll see a group called Lights. If I make sure that this is toggled on, we will see a nice light effect apply to the surface of the flag. But in this case, it's a bit too much, so I'll simply set the light folder to a transparency of 50, and that is looking great. So right now, the flag is on a white background. And for my proposal, I want to put it into context. So the canvas size of this template is quite narrow, so I'll quickly make a new document. I'll set this to 1920 by 1080 and click OK. With my document set up, I now need a background image for my flag. So over on Unsplash, I have found this really nice image by Brandon Bynum of what looks like an outdoor festival scene. This is going to work really well for the flag. So I'll open the image, copy and paste it into my new document, scale and position like so. Back in my template, I'll come and select all the layers and then drag them into my new document tab. And with them all selected, I'll use free transform to scale them down and position like so. Now in this instance, the shadow is not sitting right on the image. We can see the shadows in the image background are sitting to the right. So I'll come and use free transform to scale the shadow layer down, and holding command on Mac or control on Windows, click and drag the anchor points across to match the shadows in the image behind. So I'll quickly come and duplicate the background image at the bottom. I'll come up to filter, select blur, and add a Gaussian blur to put more focus on the flag. Next, I'll add a mask to this layer, select the gradient tool, and with my fill set to black and my foreground set to white, I'll add a gradient layer mask so as to keep some of the ground in focus. Next, I'll add a Gaussian blur to the shadow, double click on the layer to pull up the layer styles and add a color overlay to change the color of the shadow to a color that matches the scene behind. So using the template and an appropriate image background, I have been able to quickly put together a nice festival flag scene to show how the logo can be used on a flag in context. Now, for my proposal, I also wanted to show how the logo could be used on a flag in a more decorative instance. So with my new document set up, I can easily change the background image to another scene and double click into the flag smart object and change the visual. So with my two flag visuals finished, I then placed them both into a new doc, which I then included in my proposal presentation. So that is a really cool template I would recommend you use, not only to save you loads of time, but to make your proposal doc look awesome. If you want to take a closer look at the details, specifications, and invest in this template, you can find the link in the free index PDF document that accompanies this course and in the info section of this video. Links are in the description. So when putting together proposal documents, consider using appropriate in-situ visuals, as this can really help sell your design and convince a client of its merits. So back in my proposal document, another really cool in-situ visual I have used here is to show the logo used as a paint stamp for decoration at a music festival. So in the next video, I'm going to show you a really quick technique you can use to apply a paint effect to skin. See you in the next video.